This is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
Indeed, with joy and gladness, we come to hear God's word and receive from him the blessings as he comes to us in our worship service this morning. Our order of service is divine service, setting 2 on page 167. We also begin our service this morning with the order of holy baptism as we welcome Roland and Amelia to the family of God through the waters of baptism. That is on page 268. It's also up on the monitor, so you can follow along at that time. To get us started with, we do have today's our mission minute. And so Barb will share with us a little bit of what's going on in missions in our congregation.
We know that the Great Commission is go therefore and teach all nations. And so it's good for us to know what are we, as Immanuel Lutheran Church, doing to fulfill that Great Commission. And so I'm here to give you a little information about what we are doing currently or have done historically as far as supporting foreign missions. Currently, we do give monetary support to in the mission field, 2% of our undesignated budget, that's about $7,500 a year, go to support foreign missions. We do have Julie Luce, that we have been supporting for many years, who many of you know has served in Papua New Guinea. She is currently in Hong Kong right now. And the other family that we support are the Friedrich family. They were serving in Nigeria, and they are currently back from the mission field and work with an organization called Global Lutheran Outreach. So as we move forward and become more intentional with our support of foreign missions, it's always good to look and see what we're currently doing.
Thank you. And hopefully we will hear in the weeks and months to come maybe some ways that we can continue and even further our support for bringing the gospel of Jesus Christ to people around the world. Laverne would like to talk to us a little bit.
On behalf of the Dervish Society, I'd like to invite all women in Immanuel to our July outing at Bar Cafe the 22nd. If you would like to join us, I need to know by this Thursday so they can count how many are coming. So just give me a call or email me. My number and email address is in the bulletin. Hope to see a lot of you there.
I do have a concern about that sexism. Only the women can go. That's not something that would be allowed in other places. And finally, and there's lots of information, news, and notes about what's going on in the congregation, but I would like to invite everyone in the congregation, a week from tomorrow, on Monday evening, the 17th, we're having a special meeting called Confirmation Reconsidered. Some of you may be aware of the statistics revolving around confirmation and how much a failure it is. And by failure, I mean 70% of young people who are confirmed across the denomination, across churches, end up leaving the church. If 70% of the kids who are confirmed across the country leave the church for at least a period of time and maybe forever, then how can we say that this is something we need to just keep doing as if nothing's happened? So I'd like to invite you, we're going to talk about how do we reconsider and relook at confirmation in a completely different way, to try to address the terrible statistic. Now, I will tell you, Immanuel isn't quite so bad. And Melissa run the numbers for us. I think we're only about 55%. So we should pat ourselves on the back, right? Yeah, I guess not. So everyone in the congregation is invited to come a week from Monday where we talk about how we're going to look at confirmation differently. And that's Monday night on the 6th. That being said, finally, let's take a moment and share the peace of Christ with those around us.
Thank you.
dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Matthew, all authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples, and baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises, whoever believes and is baptized shall be saved. And the Apostle Peter has written, baptism now saves you. The Word of God also teaches that we are all conceived and born sinful, and are under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We would be lost forever unless delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Please be seated. How is this child named?
James Garcia.
Nolan, receive the sign of the cross both upon your forehead and your heart to mark you as one redeemed by Christ the crucified. And how is this child named? Amelia, you receive the sign of the cross both upon your forehead and your heart to mark you as one redeemed by Christ the crucified. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your strict judgment, you condemned the unbelieving world through the flood. Yet according to your great mercy, you preserved believing Noah and his family, 8 souls in all. You drowned hard-hearted Pharaoh and all his hosts in the Red Sea, yet led your people Israel through the water on dry ground, foreshadowing this washing of your baptism. Through the baptism in the Jordan of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to a blessed flood and a lavish washing away of sin. We pray that you behold Nolan and Amelia according to your boundless mercy and bless them with true faith by the Holy Spirit, that through this saving flood all sin of them, which has been inherited from Adam and which he himself has committed since, would be drowned and died. Grant that they be kept safe and secure in the holy ark of the Christian Church, being separated from the multitude of unbelievers, and serving your name at all times with a fervent spirit and a joyful hope, so that with all believers in your promise, they would be declared worthy of eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. From ancient times, the Church has observed the custom of appointing sponsors for baptismal candidates and catechumens. In the Evangelical Lutheran Church, sponsors are to confess the faith expressed in the Apostles' Creed and taught in the Small Catechism. They are, whenever possible, to witness the baptism of those they sponsor. They are to pray for them, support them in their ongoing instruction and nurture of the Christian faith, and encourage them toward the faithful reception of the Lord's Supper. They are at all times to be examples to them of the holy life of faith in Christ and love for their neighbor. Is it your intention to serve Nolan and Amelia as sponsors of the Christian faith? God enable you both to do and to will this faithful and loving work, and with his grace fulfill what we are able to do. Hear the gospel for holy baptism. They brought young children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked those who brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was greatly displeased and said to them, let the little children come to me and do not forbid them, for such is the kingdom of God. Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will by no means enter it. And he took them up in his arms, he put his hands on them, and he blessed them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and
regarding their faith. Nolan James Garcia and Amelia Ruth Peel, do you renounce the devil?
Yes, I renounce him.
Do you renounce all his works?
Yes, I renounce him.
Do you renounce all his ways?
Yes, I renounce him.
Do you believe in God the Father, Almighty Maker of heaven and earth?
Yes, I believe.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended into hell, and the third day was rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Yes, I believe.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting?
Yes, I believe.
Nolan and Amelia, do you desire to be baptized?
Yes, I believe.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us.
But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us then confess our sins to God our Father.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may fly to your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given you his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High
will lie in the shadow of the Almighty.
I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress,
my God in whom I trust.
Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place,
the Most High who is my refuge.
No evil shall be allowed to befall you.
No plague come near your tent. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High
will abide in the shadow of the Almighty.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Promised rest and the full joy of your salvation through Jesus Christ. Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
This is the gospel of the Lord.